Yo. Here we go. Hold on. Just had to close Cookie Clicker real quick. Okay. It's time to get pathing. So what we're doing today is roads. Because where we're going, we need roads. We need like a lot of roads. But before we get over to the city, I want to do some pathways around here. Because I think that'll be fun. I may need that stone cutter, so. I mean, we might as well start with the one part of our base that doesn't really have a pathway leading out, so we can just start with that and move on from there. And man, my eyes are killing me. Right. Actually, I shouldn't be using my silk touch pickaxe or my silk touch shovel. What? Oh, that's grass. That's why it's not. That's two. All right. Okay. Now we can do this. I have some nice pathing over here. Oh, right, I need the music. Get some slab. See, there we go. See, it's incredible just how nice something can look just by some small work. Yeah, let's get rid of some of this, like, hill over here, basically. We're gonna need to patch that up. Making it less bushy over here is just a good idea. See, there we... Blah. There we go. It's so satisfying just destroying everything so instantly. It's probably fine. I'm gonna convert like a whole stack of cobble into slabs. There we go. Two stacks of slab. Hello, Bard. Welcome to the stream. Wait, yeah, give me that. Why does grass work like that? In what world would you want to, when you place it on grass, why would you ever want it to be on the top? It's going pretty good. Going pretty good. I'm just making some pathways right now. Simple stuff, simple stuff. Another portal pathway is done. There you go. You're super sleepy? Yeah. Especially if you get up early, it can be really hard to stay awake. How am I out of slabs already? Give me more slab. There we go. I bet the music probably isn't helping. Why was I trying to... I was trying to break grass with a shovel. Sleep during the day, chill out at night. Yep. I mean, that's what staying up till 4 a.m. reading on your phone will get you. Definitely not talking from experience or anything. I don't know, there's just something about reading at night that is just better, you know? It's just this mood for it is just there. Like, it gets to the point where it's like, why would you read if it's not nighttime, right? Or look at comics or anything. It's like, it just becomes ingrained into you to do it at night. Why am I doing slabs? I'm just realizing now that I'm going to need to light up these pathways. And the whole reason I'm making pathways right now is to take a break from draining an ocean monument. Which literally I was only doing to get sea lanterns, so... Oh, audiobooks. Honestly, it feels like something I would enjoy, but never tried them. How am I out of slabs again? You know, the one bad thing in Minecraft that, like, nobody ever talks about is how the grass is just the most annoying thing ever. Like, nobody ever talks about it, but everybody knows it's true. It's just like, I want to build stuff. I want to build stuff. I don't want to have to clear out a ton of grass. I'm going to have to go get more cobble. Would you believe I've played on this file for like over 8 days and I'm just now making pathways between stuff? And by 8 days, I mean play time of 8 hours on, or 8 days worth of hours on this file. Water bucket would, actually. Yeah. 8 days worth of playing and I still don't have a dedicated bedroom in my base. Alright, I need to grab some deep slate stuff as well. I need some brick. Do I need two or three? I'll grab three just to be safe. There we go. That's the trick. Hold shift and then do that. Alright. You play Bedrock? I played Bedrock for the longest time until it started lagging like crazy because I was doing a bunch of redstone stuff and trying to get efficiency in all my farms, and the game just became unplayable. I was playing on console, though, and then once I got a PC, I was just like, might as well do Java, you know? Since you haven't gotten a job yet. Yeah. Honestly, probably my biggest fear is this computer, like, just dying somehow. $2,000 on this thing. It served me well, but man, it's expensive. Anyway, there we go. A path to this bridge. Which, if I'm correct, this bridge leads to the other bridge, which leads to the outdated melon farm. Yeah, because this just goes over here, and then you get to this bridge. Yeah, and there's the melon farm. Forty-seven melon slices is all this thing is giving me. Honestly, don't make a melon farm like that. It's extremely inefficient and just not a good use of resources. That led to another bridge? Nah. There's that bridge, there's the Crimson Bridge, and then there's the Blandern Bridge up there. That bridge has a name, but I don't remember what it is, and I never will. I said it like one time, and then I just forgot. Anyway. Now, over there we have, like, the village. That's the trading center. Here's our two iron farms and the pumpkin farm. Comedically bad at using Elytra. Yeah, Elytra on Bedrock is way different than Java, honestly. Yeah. Five layers of pumpkin farming right here. All fully automated. Collected by minecart hoppers and thrown into these chests. It's a lot, yeah. Then of course you got your iron farm. Over here you got all the sheep. This was fun. This, of course, is where you put in all the extra shears for the dispensers. Yeah. Anyway. It's so much better having a pathway there. Oh my, it already looks so much better than it did. Okay. Just adding that, like, simple pathway added so much, man. Come on. It's so much better than just having random ground and naturally generated terrain. It's just, like, so much better. Also kind of gives off, like, classic Minecraft vibes, which is always cool. Honestly, build more with cobble. Build more with cobble. Cobble is a completely underutilized block in this modern age. I also want to get rid of this stone because it doesn't look good. Makes it look worse. Oh yeah, the new cherry biome is pretty good. It's honestly probably my favorite biome they've added in a long time. Give me that. See, there we go. Now I gotta put all this junk away. Because we're gonna go make the actual pathway. Yeah. Right, I need to put the seeds inside the composter. Yeah. Honestly, I've never been a person to, like, make a normal house. I typically always make, like, a bunker or some other kind of base. That's just a me thing, though. In the mountains is always good. Yeah, that was like what I did is the classic thing. Anyway, it's time to head to the city. One of these days I really need to make like an actual pathway through the Nether, because it's really annoying having to fly every time. Where like all those chests full of blocks for, oh my god. Please don't. Yep. Here we go. This is where I'm making the mega build of the city. And I just wanted sea lanterns, so I spent like the last 3 months trying to drain Ocean Monument for the sole purpose of getting sea lanterns, but I'm sick and tired of doing that, so I'm just gonna build a road. Gotta go babysit your uncle's kids. Ooh. Ooh. Does not sound fun. Well, thanks for stopping by, Bard. Always nice to have somebody on. See you next time. The axe. Okay. Honestly, the most annoying thing is just trees. Like, come on. Get out of here. Do. It's always a waste of rockets. I hate that. I hate it when I do that. It's garbage. Ruining the economy. What little remains of it, I guess. After I single-handedly made, like, pumpkins the only currency worth having. Out of the way, please. I do very much like the idea of just having a ton of buildings around here. I don't know what's going to be in these stores, but I'm sure I can get creative with it. There we go. Be honest here, like, this is so much better than clearing out water. You have no idea how much better this is. You know, this is actually like the first ever real mega project I've done, or at least like in this capacity, I guess. So it's gonna be a lot of first time for everything. Oh yeah, tomorrow's song. It's not the song I was originally gonna do. But I'm actually happy with the song I'm choosing. And I love drawing Kana, who is the ponytail. I don't know, the ponytail is just so fun to draw. Kana as a character isn't one I was like super invested in before, but now, just because I like to draw her, I might just do more stuff with her because fun to draw that kind of stuff. When I draw the character more, I come up with more ideas for them, and then they end up becoming more important. That's what happened with a lot of characters, and it will continue to happen because that's just how the way the world works. The more attention you give something, the more important it shall become. This is why not bringing attention to certain things is a double-edged sword. Oh, hey, generic hell. I may need to go mine for more deep slate. more do I need? Like, two? Oh, we're just gonna have an odd number of slabs then. Oh wait, we need to do this multiple times, don't we? There is still hope. Here. We'll see what I need to do soon enough. Here. I don't know how much more I'm gonna need, but that's probably a safe bet. It was a very safe bet. It was the correct bet. I didn't even realize that this section was just here. There we go. Get out of here. Go back here to get dirt of all things. Thank you. keep shining. What? Dreams that I assumes that I never I will allow, and that there is doubt in my mind that things will go to my design. And I hold on to this plan, a pyre upon which I stand. I have the flames that burn so bright. I have a victory tonight, and yet I gather in my fear the things I never want to hear, and I would go beyond this place to see what happens when I wait. It would be so weird if you could, like, combine slab types. I was half expecting a Tribute to the King to start playing. One of the coolest things about, like, when I was writing a bunch of song lyrics for stuff was just getting to flex vocabulary. Like, it sounds arrogant because it is, but, like, getting to flex your vocabulary and then sing that flex vocabulary, it's like, it's something different. You know? Especially when you get, like, a really good rhyme out of it. I don't know. I think One Champion Against the Void is, like, the premier example of that for me. It's just, like, yes. It's an ugly tree. No. Why do you have to be like this? I guess I should count myself lucky I haven't encountered too many of these things yet, but it's so annoying when they do show up. Like, who was the guy that added ugly tree? Like, who wanted to be that guy? Are you kidding me? Let's get out of here. Finally, there's another one right there. No. It's so dark. It's a lot of tree. The tree must die. I know a lot of people just like burn down the trees, but that's just a waste of a lot of good wood, you know? Give me that. Hey. I'm so happy I made this song. This is really the song that started it all. It wasn't the first song I ever made, but it was the song that really just solidified who I am and who I want to be. And well, what's more beautiful than that? Go. I don't know why I had the end of summer as a medley in here. It makes sense thematically and on like an actual level, but like, I don't know why it's there. Because factually speaking, that melody never shows up in any other song aside from Nostalgic Medley, which is literally its job to reference the other songs. So... The End of Summer is not a very common song to be referenced. I don't think it's referenced in Serenity of Autumn either. I believe I referenced Winding Trees instead. She doesn't even have anything to do with the Random Song series, but... So Cattail is just like a feel-good song. Or at least 2021's version is a feel-good song. Debatably, you could say 2022 is as well. I'd even argue 2022 might be a bit more feel-good than 2021 just because context, but... It's almost getting to the point where 2022 is becoming, like, a referenced one, and a nostalgic one at that. I don't know. It's strange. I have no idea what I'm going to do for next year's, because I want it to be different from these three. 2021 set the stage and is just like a feel-good, happy song. 2022's whole point was expanding on the previous. That was like the whole point of not just the song, but like the album in general. So, I'd say it succeeded at that. 2023 got to be a little bit unique, but it's still... It's very referential as a song. 2023 is the most referential out of the Cattails, and it's by quite a bit. Like, that thing is crammed full of medleys. I basically fit in as many as I could with the song still sounding good. I'm full on sticks? Why? Again, you put some of the dirt away. Oh. I think what makes 2023 hit very different from 2021 and 2022 is that it's not inherently part of the story of RSV2. Because RSV2's story is, like, a lot more ambiguous than RSV1's. It's more random, you know, living up to the title name, actually. Thematically, it's about the seasons. So where do you fit Cattail into that? Well, it falls under the fall category, or the autumn section, I should say. But other than that, good question. just keep it on the pickaxe while we're doing that. I say, and then immediately do it with the shovel. You know, I've heard of people, like, losing their netherite shovels due to being careless with breaking dirt. I don't know how you do that, considering mine's only in the yellow, or the light green right now. It's not even in the yellow. We have quite a ways to go until we reach, like, the ocean area. How's the road just look? Very nice, very nice. I don't like this part hanging out over here, though. Feeling so wiped out right now. We've made good progress, though. Get this tree garbage out of here. I've interfered with my everything for the last time. This one's in the shuffle. Oh, I think I debated myself about including this one in the shuffle. I ended up doing so. Despite the fact that it's very quiet. Out of here. Look how much dirt that is. It's a lot of dirt. Here. Boom. You know, I could have just taken the stairs, but that would have taken forever. Okay, we're back. Get rid of some of these logs and dirt before headed over to the pumpkin farm to get pumpkins and do that. That ILA really tried it, huh? Marine separates. Mushrooms, apples. There we go. Oak logs. Some other logs. Nope, get over here. Put all this stone away. Some bricks away. Fit all of it. Okay. To the iron farms. That's a lot of iron golems just wandering around over there. And the pumpkin farm. Ugh. Alright. I guess I could talk a little bit about Undelia. Undelia is pretty obviously originally spawned from Undertale. A lot of the characters are pretty similar, at least in appearance. But Undelia really kind of became its own thing when I wanted to do other things with the characters. Thus, it was decided to not just have it be like Undertale crossover thing, but instead be its own thing. Which is where the three crystals come from, actually. So, the three crystals on the Undelia cover are basically intrinsically linked to the main story. At least at first. The crystals themselves serve mostly as plot devices, so you can get from point A to point B. And so it gives you a reason to visit every area instead of just, you have to go through this area to get to the castle. So. Because you got the caverns, you have the forest, and you have the, I always forget what the areas are actually called, but you have like the, you have like the factory. Factories like got the lava stuff. You know, standard factory fare. It's got lava. It's got electricity. It's got all that stuff. The castle's top. The only mountain. And it's got ice. It's got the rainbow bridge. The whole point is to get the crystals, the rainbow bridge, to get out of the dimension. But, you know, everybody's been trapped in there for a while. And it's not like they're gonna die in there or anything. They're just, nobody gets in, nobody gets out. But then when somebody gets in, that raises a few questions. But since nobody's tried getting out with the crystals in quite a while, because why would you? There's no point. It's up to our intrepid heroes to gather the crystals again. Try to break out. That's the base story of the first act. And technically the third act, but the third act has a lot more going on in it. And of course, the second act takes after the genocide route. Everybody dies. Because the whole point is to make the main character feel awful. After they get possessed by one of their friends. And that's just, it's just a bad time for everybody. But not that kind of bad time, you know? Now it's just the X. Somehow my elytra is not damaged. Alright, it's time to basically just torture myself again by going back. To the place. Because imagine what we're going to be doing for the next 2 hours. Tub time. Wonderful. All right, we also need to bring out here. Okay. Water is so strange. Okay. Get over here. Keep backing up, and everything will be great. Give me everything you can. Somehow I've gotten multiple of three both times, but I will not question it. Let me back up, please. Thank you. Some crazy stuff going on over here. All right. for once. Everything's great. Can I clear it all out? Because we gotta go this way. Gotta keep going. Get out of here. I should probably move my microphone slightly out of the way so I can actually see the full screen. I actually don't know which way to go. Yes, this way is correct. Imagine trying to drain an entire ocean. That would be awful. Oh, I didn't mean to go that far. Ah, yes, the most underrated song on the jukebox. I really don't know why I did this one as a doubleheader with Final Pyre. I guess because Final Pyre isn't like a great upload. So I suppose it makes sense. Only 1.5 hearts this time. I'm probably gonna add like some sort of railing to the entire outside. Just to make it easier to walk around. God, dude, can you not lightning? Fine, I'll let it play. This is the one song I want to remake most out of any song I have made. I Like, I love the idea behind it, but the execution left much to be desired. And perhaps some re-instrumentalization for some of the members would be prudent. Take down the gravel over here. Now we place the gravel. Where the heck do we place the gravel? I don't know where the gravel goes. Hmm. Oh, I see it. I see it. We expanded this way. On the bright side, I at least know where we're going. That's just one of those big areas, too. Shame. I'm realizing if I do leave any water anywhere, I need to, like, block it off somewhat. Or, like, have it be ponds made of slabs. Waterlogged slabs. Because, otherwise there ain't gonna be much. Get out of here. I'm out. Well, we made a lot of progress there. We can do three more buckets. Backing up. Perfect. Don't ask me how kelp grows out of the prismarine. I would not be able to answer you. What's nice about this one is that it's just a simple back and forth sweeping motion. It's a small, relatively contained area. See, one of the things about the Gauntlet Extended is that none of the songs are actually really extended. So I'd like to change that. Scorched, Drowned, Poisoned, and Steamed definitely all also need to be changed. I think Failsafe is mostly fine, just some re-instrumentalization. I love that Failsafe is just like a remix of Shoot Leaf, basically. Or the Failsafe melody is a remix of the Shoot Leaf melody. I don't know. That just makes me smile. Here we go. We're back on the grind. Out of here. Okay. Need to make sure they are still stocked up. As we can't have them running on empty. It's just a waste of lava. Not like, you know, it matters because we have infinite lava, but... Almost down to the bottom of the planet, but we're not quite there yet. There we go. How much fire is left in this thing? Up we go. Guess that means we're going this way. Not super enthused about doing this, because it's another big section. kind of sucks, but. Sooner we do the big sections, sooner we can get to the smaller ones. That entire fall only lost me 2 hearts. It's pretty good, you know? Pretty good value. It's nice to just bounce. Get out of here. Now give me all the things. I want all the things. Okay. My guess is that, there we go. They're all out. Twenty-five, twenty-four. Time to clear the area. Thank you. It could have been bad if I accidentally broke that. Give me. Alright, eventually I'm gonna need to probably get more gravel again. You might want to get out of here, fish. And we still got a lot of gravel. Thank you. Alright, I need all this. All the kelp. Oh. Couldn't sleep, played some COD, and came back. I don't know how long ago you posted that chat message. If that was like an hour ago, then. Whoops. Yeah. Never been a Call of Duty person. Maybe it's because I didn't grow up with it, but Call of Duty was never my thing. And honestly, I'm kind of glad it was never my thing, because considering the state of the franchise right now, well, ooh. Also, I've said it before, but if, like, a really popular game just called COD came out, all the Call of Duty fans would be furious, because they'd be like, but COD is Call of Duty, but it wouldn't be Call of Duty anymore. Yeah, technically Black Ops 2 and Black Ops 3 are, like, called bot. So. Huh. Does it make Black Ops 1 boo? Let's fly back. Yeah. So, yeah, I don't know. I will say, though, when you can't sleep, the thing to do is probably just, I don't know, when I can't sleep, I typically find it's like that really annoying part where you're tired but you can't sleep, so you can't really do anything super intensive like draw, but you also can't just sit there doing nothing. Typically I just read when that happens, but that probably contributes to me staying awake for longer, so. No, wrong one. Did not want that as a screenshot, but I didn't have a choice. My chair is very squeaky. It's also very old. It's like getting ripped. I don't know how long I've had this thing, but I've had it ever since. I've had it since I started streaming, so it's been two and a half, almost 3 years of streaming, because the third year anniversary of Cattail, Military Cattail, is coming up in January, so this chair is at least 3 years old, and I use it like almost every day. Ignore that. We're just gonna wait here for some pumpkins. We shall see. You know, I'm realizing after this, I have to go finish drawing the picture that I was drawing and then make the video for the song for tomorrow. Because I already missed 1 week this month, I'm not missing two. I might as well try and get ahead of the curve at that point. Try and make some pictures ahead of time. I've wanted to do Song of the Bantling Threshold for the past few weeks, but it's one of those pictures that has a lot of characters in it, and I want to get the character details correct, so it's not like a really easy picture to make, like flower and spots or final pyre. No, it's got like a lot more to do. That's why I did Falling Petals last week, is because the only one you had to draw was Delaz, and while Delaz has some more intricate parts and probably has some of the most detail of the Andelia cast, Delaz is also not a human, so I don't have to worry about doing good human proportions or anything. So, Advantage Flower. I can't wait to do the picture for Crossroads. Crossroads is coming out in December. I really want to release this one because, ooh, the picture. It's also why I wanted to start releasing some Andelia songs, you know? Build up to Crossroads. I was talking about, like, the Andelia axe before. End of Act 1 right here. That's enough pumpkin waiting. Cyan, lime, yellow, and blue. Cyan, lime, light blue, and yellow. lime, cyan, or that's light blue, that's cyan. Orange wool. Gotta get those banners. Ow. Oh, right. That's light blue. I think I actually need to check over here if magenta. Yeah, that is what happened. Okay. Okay. Are all these cauldrons filled? No. They are not. Quite interesting. Quite interesting. See, there we go. Now the road is on the map. I like how that's like a mini Cattail icon right there. I don't know. I find that cool. Did I finish the observatory? I thought I did. Correct, I did. I knew the path was gonna show up. I knew it. I just zoom off. It's so nice actually having like a pathway there now instead of it being like stuck in the ground. Hmm. can kind of see the path. Yep, eventually this will be like a long hallway or a long strip of road with giant buildings on each side. Going up to the mountains, there's going to be streets. There's going to be like fountains, and it's going to be great. It's going to be great. I'm out of rockets. Well, shoot. Where the heck is... I don't have any gunpowder. Okay, hold on. It's fine. We can just walk back. It's gonna take 30 minutes, but... coincidentally, we got 30 minutes left in the stream, so... where the heck did I leave the backpack upgrade? You know, I'm thinking back to like those old tutorial worlds on the 360. How many people worked on those? Because there was some big builds in those worlds. How many people worked on the tutorial worlds? And I imagine there was like a maximum of 8 players online at once too. So they had to work with that limitation probably. Please tell me I just like left it here. Honestly, it's such a bad coincidence running out of fireworks and losing the box. Thank you. I don't think I could have placed it in here because... Yeah, because there's nowhere to place it. So I had to have placed it somewhere else. Oh, it's right here. Okay. Yeah, I need a restock on gunpowder. How's our gunpowder stores? Not super good. I need to make that creeper farm. You can now kind of see the path. Now so you can like see a micro scale of our base. Since I've been over here. Welcome back. To the deep slate deep dive. Just gonna be the stream. Efficiency 5, by the way. there we go. All that deep slate is mine. How much more? Oh, we get redstone. I don't think we need redstone, but could come in handy. Let's just not deal with any of this. Also, I like how Plants vs. Zombies likes my computer more than Minecraft. Despite the fact that like the pumpkin machine probably should like my game a lot, it doesn't. I'm guessing that's a lot of deep slate. Right. I'm pretty sure I dug most of this out just for the deep slate and then redstone. Maybe gold. Definitely not lapis and not diamond. I like how diamonds are like the most useless ore down here. The only one that's potentially more useless is lapis. But even then, you could use it for blue dye. Who cares about diamonds? I want deep slate. Casual 16 diamonds. All right. Oh, I missed a lot. Slaves. Now, I wonder how long the city is going to take to build. I imagine probably, like, this time next year I'll still be building it, but... you never know. See, I really like coral, but you can definitely tell there's like a couple little things that I've gotten better at over the years with songs. Is one of those songs I'd like to touch up and then release. I don't know. Iron? What is iron doing down here? let's head over here and get this done. You know, I'm just thinking about it right now, but, like, do people treat, like, Super Smash Brothers as the definitive version of those characters? What the? Whoops. Yeah. Do people, like, treat the characters in Smash Bros. As their definitive versions? Because, like, or at least the Nintendo characters, I should say. Because that's, like, where their personalities are showcased most at the forefront, right? Everybody has a different moveset, a different thing going on. Different emotions at play, different cinematic cutscenes. Is that just how, like, people view the characters? I mean, from an outside perspective, if you haven't played that franchise, that is your definitive version of that character. That's kind of dangerous. The Smash team has a lot of responsibility to be faithful to the franchises, then. Because if they aren't, then they're potentially sending people the wrong message about those franchises. Something I guess you just got to think about a bit is, like, you know, what is the audience here? If this is a general audience, how do I put the best foot forward for as many characters as possible? I get why people are so upset about representation in Smash now, because, like, from a completely casual perspective, a lot of franchises are just kind of screwed over. Like, you must think Fire Emblem must be the most boring thing ever, because every single character plays the same, and there's a billion of them, so it just seems like generic anime game. It's like the little subtextual things that just add up. Because if nothing else, Smash Brothers can be used as a giant advert for other games. To get people interested in franchises that they might not otherwise have not be interested in. So if representation for a franchise is poor, then that not only hurts Smash, but it also hurts that franchise, I'd argue, even more. Because if the franchise is poorly represented, a la Kirby, it's not going to be as popular mainstream, or at least with the people who play Smash, because they're missing out on important parts of the franchise. might as well just do it this year, actually. I say I don't know a lot because I don't know things. That's why you think, so you can organize thoughts into a comprehensive manner. Is now the most common block in the game. It's interesting to think about, but deep slate is the most common block in the game. But unlike stone, the only thing down here that competes with deep slate is tuff and gravel. But regular stone has diorite, andesite, granite. There should probably be another, like, stone variant down here. Also, look at that space. Where the heck did we get 23 diamonds? Call it there. We had a good run, and we got a lot done. And next time we'll get even more done. Until then, Cattail, signing off. Bye.